Let's look at finding dissertations that might help you with finding out what subjects have been explored and also serving as source materials for you. Some databases already include dissertations, but you can search the full range yourself by going to the Dissertations and Theses Global. So let's just use the title list and go direct. There are really two possibilities. You see Dissertations and Theses Global, as well as Dissertations and Theses at Rutgers. So this is a subset, and if that's your intent, then you're in business. And
is the database okay?
I'm sorry?
Is the database okay?
Yes, yes. These are dissertations from the mid-1800s up to the present. Rutgers is roughly from 1995 up to the present, but this is a subset of the bigger database, depending on your purpose. So let's look at Dissertations and Theses Global. Once again, we have a description. Oh, I see I was off a little bit here. 1637 versus 1861. But let's click on Connect. This is a ProQuest search engine screen in relationship to the sum of the points we discussed yesterday. You can create an account here called My Researcher. When we mark things, we'll be creating a file. You see the file folder here. And over here, when we enter our search, if we have a more complex search, we can add rows as we see fit. And then underneath here, there are more specific fields that we can use for searching, depending on what we know. So I'm interested in learned helplessness. And I'm also curious to know what's been done in the last 20 years or so. Clearly, I have to do some narrowing. I have an awful lot of results here. There might be some specific conditions here. I can go back to my search and add some more terms. Well, I didn't get rid of much, did I? I can narrow the date range, perhaps, or continue to read the first 20 or so and see if there's something more that will help me limit my search. A lot of times you'll have more information. You may have a particular person's name, which we can search with. Member limit for author. I can leave my date. Okay, this is not good. Oh, this is why this stayed. I forgot. I'm sorry. Okay, that'll do it. Now I have three results. You can see full text is available for some of these. And if I'm interested in this first listing, then I would have to request a copy. You know this is going to take us to the screen we looked at yesterday, where we could place an article request. We can also place a request for the dissertation as well. And if you plan on doing that, you want to be sure you include the name of the university that awarded the degree and the date. that will be very helpful to the staff in getting this for you. Actually, I'm curious about this one. I can look at full text, I can look at the full record. I can also, the preview PDF is the first 24 pages of the dissertation. And I can start to read it here if I wish. Do you have any questions about this? There are other elements that you could be searching on that are part of this record. You notice the name of an advisor. If I wanted to limit this to Rutgers, I could also have used the subset database. Maybe there is a subject heading I've identified that I can, the list is given to me. That would be a great way of reducing the retrieval. And I can also limit for dissertations or theses. Do you want to see the requesting? Would that be of help to you? Okay. We'll go back to Dr. Flynn. And we'll click here. And once again, the information from the record has rolled over into my request, which is very nice. There's a note field here, and this is where you could enter the name of the university. And then you have your submit button, and then in a week's time you should have some further news on the availability. Do you have any questions about this? You're also going to see these in databases. The one that springs to mind right away is PsycINFO. Dissertations are fully integrated into that database. I should also mention to you in terms of the Rutgers dissertations and theses. As the one of the requirements until recently for the submission of a dissertation. Now that process is completely electronic, the submission and deposit and so on. But before that time, folks had to submit three copies of their dissertations. One of them came, well, two copies came to the library. One went into a deep dark archive. And the other came to us to make available to folks who wanted to look at the dissertation. They are here. We've always been led to believe that the everything that has been submitted to Rutgers is part of the dissertations and theses database. We just recently completed a project that indicates that is not the case. So if you know you're looking for something for a degree that was done here from roughly 73, 74, up to, say, 2010. You can find it in the online catalog, but it may not be part of the database, in which case the print is going to be available to you for a limited long period. The reference desk librarians would have to retrieve the item for you, and then you could borrow it just like a reserve book for a week's time. You need to be very careful about this because the day you borrow counts as part of the 7-day borrowing period, as well as the day you bring it back. So you want to adjust that in your time. And there's also, is there still a fine associated with that?
I mean,
the reserve
probably,
items?
It'll probably be waived. But the thing is, if this is like, it might be waived. But the thing is, since this might be the only existing copy, they take it very seriously. And they want to make sure that it gets returned. So they might just fine you, scare you, and bring you back. But don't quote me on that. It's really up to them upstairs what they want to do.
we have also recently been talking about moving our print copies up to the circulating collection. But now that we have a much better idea of how few of them are duplicated in the database, they're going to stay right where they are in a closed stack arrangement under lock and key. And Forrest, just for your information, all of the theses submitted for the Jazz History Program are available in the Institute.
Well, some of them are online.
They might be as part of this. And the other place you can look is in the repository on the core. But they should really be in both places.
Okay.
Do you have any questions about this process? Okay. Thank you.
Okay.